Finals fever is gripping the nation this weekend, with AFL and NRL teams battling it out to keep their premiership dreams alive. And it kicked off with the Broncos' extraordinary win over the Storm. Let's bring in our reporters in Brisbane and Sydney. First to Ashlyn Krakelis at Suncorp Stadium. Ashlyn, they had plenty to cheer about at the Cauldron last night.
The atmosphere was just amazing, Soph. And for Brisbane fans, after a lean couple of years, they are loving seeing the Broncos once again strong in September. Last night, they were simply awesome, smashing the Storm 26-0, their first win over Melbourne since 2009 here at Suncorp Stadium, smashing that 14-game losing streak they had against them. Of course, celebrations went long and hard into the night. Take a look. Perhaps the only moment that the stadium went silent here was during the 73rd minute of play, when Melbourne fullback Ryan Pappenhausen fell awkwardly in a tackle, unfortunately breaking his ankle, an injury that's made even more cruel by the fact that he's worked so hard to just get back on the field after a serious kneecap injury. It made a bad night even worse for Melbourne. They will get another shot next week. Brisbane, meanwhile, are just one win away from making the NRL Grand Final. We haven't won a premiership in 17 years, Soph, and of course we are daring to dream this morning.
Yep, they are the ones to beat, Ashlyn. Thank you. Let's go to Bianca Bolza at Bluebet Stadium in Penrith now. Bianca, we are still hours away from kickoff, but the fan base is already building there.
Oh, yeah, Sophie, it's grown tenfold since I last saw you. And come 4:05 this afternoon, we will see Bluebet Stadium here in Penrith packed out. It is going to be a massive game, the qualifying finals between the Penrith Panthers and the New Zealand Warriors. Now, I tried to find fans from both sides of the fence today, but if you want to live in Penrith, you pretty much have to support the Panthers. Isn't that right, guys? Who's going to win tonight? Now, Kylie's already got her minor premier shirt. They only got that the other day. They made the merch pretty quick.
Yep, they sure do.
Who do you think's going to win?
Panthers, of course.
Very good answer. And are you going to be here tonight, actually?
Sure am. Yeah.
Good. All right, what about you, Zach? Are you going to be here?
No, but I can watch it on 9 live and free on 9 and 9 now. Oh,
that's a very good plug there, sir. Thank you very much for that. Also, 7:50, we've got the Sharks versus the Roosters. Now, that's going to be a big one. Whoever loses that will be kicked out. Let's just hope that the Sharks win for Jane's sake and really for everybody else's.
Up, up, Cronulla.
Good on you, Vivi. Thank you. And Clint has the rest of the day's sports news.
Thank you so much. So in the Broncos, they're into the grand final qualifier for the first time in 6 years, smashing the Storm in a sellout at Suncorp. While for Blues fans in the AFL, they're daring to dream. For the latest footy finals news, Broncos legend Sam Thaiday and senior reporter at AFL.com.au, Cal Toomey. Gents, good morning. Sam, you look pretty happy. Smile on the dial. They had a plan. It worked. They broke a hoodoo. They could go all the way this year.
Well, you're lucky you have me on this morning. Yeah. I was feeling a bit hoarse this morning, in all honesty.
Yes.
Had to weather a storm last night. I know Father's Day was a couple of weeks ago, but I've got all my best dad jokes this morning. But it was absolutely fantastic to watch the Broncos break that hoodoo against the Melbourne Storm. Such a long, long running win streak by the Melbourne Storm. I think Christian Welsh, that's the first time in his career that he has lost to the Brisbane Broncos. So they came out there with a game plan and really threw the Melbourne Storm off their game.
What the end of the Storm? Because it was a very unlike Storm performance, unlike Craig Bellamy performance. Also Ryan Pappenhausen, we have to mention him this morning and we give him a shout out. We won't be showing the incident, but you can see this Instagram post with the caption, "Here we go again." This is just terrible considering what he's gone through, Sam.
Yeah, very much so. Craig Bellamy wasn't happy in the box, and I'm sure he's not going to be happy now as a coach. Getting a superstar like Ryan Pappenhausen back out there on the field, a player who is so electric and is such a game breaker, to go down to another cruel injury. Rugby league can give you so much, but it can also take away so much as well. So on a personal note, my thoughts are with Ryan Pappenhausen. We know that he can bounce back from these big injuries, and I'd love to see him back out there on the field at some some point in time bigger and better than he was before.
Yeah, well said. The footy community great at wrapping their arms around players like Pappy. Cal, to you in Melbourne, some Carlton fans probably haven't slept, which is fair enough. They're through to week two of the finals for the first time since 2013. How do you rate the performance?
Yeah, I was there last night, Clint, in the press box. It was a pretty loud roar at the end of the game. Look, they were pretty impressive, you must say, in that first half particularly. Five goals up, they managed to really get the game on their terms. It was not without a bit of a fight back, though, from the Swans late. They did get within a goal with the final minute there to play, but they were too good in the end, the Blues. They just have weapons across the field, don't they? And we didn't even need to see Charlie Curnow dominate, so that's in store potentially for next week, where they will be without Harry Mackay, who's going into concussion protocol. So they'll miss him next week against the Demons. Both sides, of course, set to lose a couple of players there. I know you're getting nervous already for that one, Clint. It was a big result on Thursday night.
We'll take us back to Thursday night because the Magpies have a week off, but their lawyers don't. They'll be working hard to get Braden Maynard off at the tribunal. He's been sent straight there. What'll happen?
Oh, who knows, really? It's a couple of days away and there's precedence on both sides of this. We've seen players get off for this type of action. We've seen players get suspended for it. Even just last year, Patrick Cripps was able to get off his charge and obviously go on to win a Brownlow medal. I think it's going to be coming down to whether he could have braced differently. Obviously, he made connection with him through his shoulder, whether he could have done that with his arms or hands. Look, it's so split second, isn't it? But no doubt it's going to be one of the biggest tribunal cases in recent years because there's a berth in the preliminary final and potentially the grand final up for stakes here.
Yeah, Cal Toomey, Sam Thaiday, thanks so much, gents. And don't miss your chance to witness real glory in the 2023 NRL and NRLW Telstra Premiership Grand Final as the final competitors go head-to-head at Core Stadium Sunday, October 1st. Tickets are selling fast right now. Secure yours. NRL.com/tickets. Okay, now to the new platform giving fans exclusive access to elite athletes, and a few familiar faces have already jumped aboard.
NRL's James Tedesco and soccer superstar Kaya Simon were the first to sign up to GOATED, alongside creator and cricket legend Nathan Lyon. And I'm pleased to say that Nathan and Kaya join us now in the studio. Welcome to you both. We'll start with you, Nathan. GOATED. What does it mean and how does it work?
What's it mean?
It's the goat. Good.
He's the goat.
It's a good question. But, no, my project behind this was I want to give back to the game that's given me so much. And this is a way that I could probably reach out to a lot more country kids. Being a country kid myself, if I had access to Shane Warne when I was a kid growing up, then that's the idea of it. Then they can hopefully... We can hopefully aspire young boys and girls to play the games that they love and by getting in touch with some of their favourite athletes.
Well, Kai, why did you want to get involved?
Yeah, I think when that opportunity kind of came across to me, like Nathan, similar passion in terms of inspiring the next generation, giving them, I guess, that exclusive access to the life behind an athlete who they see on TV, playing on the football pitch, or the cricket pitch, and for me it just seemed like it was the right fit. And if I was growing up, a young kid growing up these days, I would love to have access to a platform like this where I can see my favourite athletes, what they do in the gym, on the pitch, what they eat, all the small details I think that makes a holistic athlete.
So is it a website, is it an app, and what do you hope fans get out of it? What will they see?
Yeah, hopefully they get access to the athletes who are jumping on board. But, yeah, you can jump on goatedverse.com.au and they whack your email in there and then you get access to videos. So I've sat down with, for me personally, a sports psych, batting, bowling coaches, but also a strength coach as well. So just getting a really insight into how I prepare, both mentally, physically, but also tactically. I'll sit down and review test matches that we've played in for Australia, just recent Ashes. But yeah, it's just an insight and way that I feel that we can give back as role models to so many different kids around the world.
And Kaya, in terms of the Matildas and what they did recently, it's been an extraordinary few months. Can an app like this help sort of induce even more fans, draw more fans into the sport, do you think?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we had an incredible few months with the Matildas here on home soil, which was amazing. But I think if there's a time now where young athletes can really, I guess, nurture that passion that they have from seeing us play on the world stage just recently, then what better platform than having GOATED and access to the athletes that you look up to and that are role models, and hopefully...
Have you been on the phone to Sam?
Haven't
get in,
yet,
get in, get
but
involved.
She might be on the list. But yeah, no, list. Look, it's a platform that, you know, that's kind of at Nathan's discretion, being the founder, but it's a platform where other athletes can give access to those young kids. And yeah, what better way to see your role models, what they're doing, you know, off the pitch and out of their football kit.
And Nathan, we have to ask you about your calf and your recovery and whether you're going to be back for summer.
Yeah, definitely be back. Really good week this week. Back bowling, running, which is, it's been 10 weeks now since I blew my calf, but it's all my rehab's on goaded, so you can check it all out. But, but no, yeah, be back for the summer and I can't wait.
Good awesome. Stuff. Nathan, Kaya, thanks so much.